This section should give a short introduction to frostbite, hypothermia, heat cramps, heat syncope, heat exhaustion, and heat stroke. When frost or cold injury occurs, the skin, and later the blood vessels, tendons and muscles, freeze. We can divide frost injuries into two groups: superficial frostbite and deep frostbite. The dangerous factor when it comes to frost injuries is that often one is given no warning before the damage has already been done. This is because the skin rapidly becomes numb and the pain is felt just briefly. An untreated frost injury may cause tissue death, resulting in damaged organs having to be amputated. Superficial frostbite will only cause damage to the outer layer of skin. The deep-lying organs will still function. The symptoms of superficial frostbite are: damaged area is mobile in respect to underlying tissue. Skin is hard. Initially, a piercing-like feeling. Later, no sensation. And white, wax-like skin. Treatment. When treating superficial frostbite, it is very important to defrost or thaw the frozen area slowly in order to prevent further tissue damage. Furthermore, it is very important that the injured area is not exposed to cold again. Further treatment of superficial frostbite is to carefully remove gloves, footwear, and rings. Not start treatment to thaw if there is a chance of renewed exposure to frost. Thaw the damaged area by putting it in direct contact with your own skin. Do not rub. If indoors and the patient is not going back outdoors, a small glass of alcohol can be given. Give the patient pain-relieving medicine. Do not mix this with alcohol. After the painful thawing process, the injured area should be covered carefully. Elevate the injured level to prevent swelling. Avoid thrusts or blows to the wound. Blemishes may appear after about 1 to 2 days and should not be manipulated. A deep frost injury develops over a period of time. When it has developed, the skin, muscles, sinews, blood veins and bones are frozen solid. Symptoms. At first, the symptoms of deep frost injury are those of superficial frostbite. The skin may turn blue and later black gangrene. The casualty may lose sensation. The skin may be stiff and cannot be moved in respect to underlying tissue. Treatment. The importance when treating deep frost injury is first of all to prevent the injury from deteriorating and to ensure that the patient as rapidly as possible receives medical treatment. The general principle of treating hypothermia is to rewarm the casualty over the same time period that they became cold. Therefore, if they have spent 5 minutes in freezing water, then they can be rewarmed quickly. When the body temperature decreases, a number of chemical and biological reactions take place. The body functions retard, and we may have problems with respiration, metabolism, and pulse frequency. The need for oxygen is reduced. When the body temperature falls below 35 degrees Celsius, the condition is called hypothermia. We can divide hypothermia into three groups: mild hypothermia, moderate hypothermia, and major hypothermia. Press the buttons for additional information. When the casualty suffers from mild hypothermia, the body temperature ranges from 32 degrees to 35 degrees Celsius. Safe temperature, where the body still has control of the situation by implementing certain actions in order to prevent heat loss and increase heat production. The symptoms of mild hypothermia are shaky, pale skin, fast pulse, fast respiration, slightly increased blood pressure, increased sugar content in the urine. Mild hypothermia is treated by When the casualty suffers from moderate hypothermia, the body temperature ranges from 30 to 32 degrees Celsius. The body no longer compensates for the loss of heat, and major hypothermia may develop if the patient is not removed from the cold area. The symptoms of moderate hypothermia are irrational behavior. The patient may, for example, decide to undress although he is cold. Loss of memory for the period right before and right after the injury. Shaking stops. Stiff muscles. Enlarged pupils. Decreased consciousness. Lower blood pressure. Difficult to feel the pulse. Reduced oxygen consumption. Danger of ventricular fibrillation at less than 32 degrees Celsius. Heat cramps often occur after excessive sweating The treatment of moderate hypothermia is careful movement and/or transportation of the patient. If the patient by himself is able to step into a warm bath, rewarming can be done, starting at 36 degrees Celsius, increasing to 40 to 42 degrees Celsius. Rewarming should be done over the same length of time as passed when the hypothermic condition took place. Keep extremities out of the bath water. Observe the patient carefully during this heating process. There is a certain danger of ventricular fibrillation or complete heart stop. Discontinue the heating process when the patient wakes up or when the body temperature raises above 34 degrees Celsius. Bring the patient to the hospital as soon as possible. When the casualty suffers from major hypothermia, the body temperature is less than 30 degrees Celsius. The patient appears to be dead. The body no longer protects itself from the cold. The symptoms are coma. Muscle stiffness decreases, cold skin, can feel no pulse, heart frequency is approximately 10 beats per minute, almost no respiration, frequency is approximately 2 to 4 inhalations per minute. The brain can, at a body core temperature of 20 degrees Celsius, endure approximately 25 minutes of circulation failure. It is difficult, almost impossible, to treat major hypothermia with a positive result. Treatment as for mild hypothermia. Immediate transportation to a hospital. Heat cramps often occur after excessive sweating precipitated by strenuous exercise. The body temperature is usually not elevated. Administration of sodium chloride and water to drink relieves the cramps. The symptoms of heat syncope range from sudden vertigo, lightheadedness, to severe fatigue and loss of consciousness. Sweating is visible, and body temperature may be elevated. The person is often pale. Treat by removing the person from the heat to rest. Vertigo, headache, and nausea. Initially, the skin is cool and clammy. Later, body temperature tends to be normal or subnormal. Administration of water and salt is often required. The patient should be examined in order to find the cause of the high temperature. It could be epilepsy. A failure of the thermostat in the brain causes this condition. The body becomes dangerously overheated due to a high fever or prolonged exposure to heat. In some cases, it follows heat exhaustion when sweating ceases and the body cannot be cooled by evaporation. Heat stroke can occur suddenly, causing unconsciousness within minutes. This may be signaled by the casualty feeling uneasy and ill. Heat strike is recognized by headache, dizziness and discomfort, restlessness and confusion, hot, flushed and dry skin, a rapid deterioration in the level of response, a full, bounding pulse, body temperature over 40 degrees Celsius. In order to treat heat strike, your aims are to lower the casualty's body temperature as quickly as possible and to arrange removal of the casualty to hospital. Quickly move the casualty to a cool place. Remove as much of his outer clothing as possible and fan and administer tepid sponging. Call for an ambulance. Wrap the casualty in a cold, wet sheet and keep it wet until his temperature falls to 38 degrees Celsius under the tongue or 37.5 degrees Celsius under the armpit. If the casualty's response deteriorates or he becomes unconscious, open the airway, check breathing and pulse, and be prepared to resuscitate if necessary. Place him in the recovery position. When the casualty's temperature has fallen to a safe level, replace the wet sheet with a dry one. Monitor the casualty carefully until help arrives. If the casualty's temperature rises again, repeat the cooling process.